Listen, Euron, and gather round. I want to have a chat. I've got a big complaint to make about a blooming rat. I'd like to hear your views as well. Go on, don't mince your words. This rat, he thinks he owns my boat. Half or perhaps two-thirds. He's been a pain. Oh, yes, he has, to me, all summer long. Can't someone in this town of ours please put to rights his wrong? Just look at how he leaps about, a Labrador in size. Good day, my man, the fat rat said. The captain nearly cried. How many sailors' logs and books have your teeth ripped to bits? You're heading for a nasty end. You've only half your wits. This sailing boat belongs to me, not you, you lump of dirt. Your ugly mug's not welcome here, you nasty little squirt. My sailors hate the things you do. You only bring them grief. Why, half their food is gobbled up by your great big front teeth. I left a ruined house one day, and seawards made my way. I saw your boat parked on the shore, right near the ocean's spray. So in that boat I made my home, though no one came to chat. I spent the winter on my own, I never chewed the fat. Then sailors came, disturbed the peace, and made my poor head spin. I hardly had a minute's peace from all their hammer's din. Silent, scared, and hard of heart, the captain chanced on me. His men, had they no shame at all? Just chattered on, carefree. I ran and hid, and while I did, some oil they brought and tipped, then singing, pulled her down the beach, till in the sea she slipped. With all this chasing to and fro, they drove me up the wall. The crew it was who started it, I did no harm at all. They brought the rigging, brought the ropes, the decks they charged about. They fixed the anchor, mast and stuff, with many a scary shout. To make me feel more comfortable, they put food in the store. And when they turned their backs, I ate till I could eat no more. But now they want to throw me out. What crime did I commit? They say I've got to leave the boat. They say, get out of it. Through winter's nights I stayed on watch till my poor eyes grew dim. While I stood guard for them, my friends, that lazy lot, slept in. What's brought you here, you big fat rat? Just pack your bags and quit. My store was filled right up with rice. Now every bag you've split. My clothes have all got teeth marks in. My jacket's gnawed right through. Get off my boat. Go on, buzz off. Find something else to chew. Look, why not stroll along the beach? You're bound to find canoes. If pleasing me is what you want, well, test a few, then choose. Why leave a comfy place like this? My belly I can fill. Drink water cold, eat food in the hold, and pick best bits at will. Sometimes rice, sometimes tea, sometimes sugar sweet, perhaps a bit of pudding too. A really tasty treat. Were I to leave the captain's boat, jump ship upon a whim, why, all the town would know for sure that I was pretty dim. And goodness me, they'd not be wrong if they thought I'd gone nuts. I'd be a laughing-stock to them. There'd be no ifs or buts. You're forcing me, against my will, to leave my cosy nest. Two up, two downs, just not my thing. Armchairs and all the rest. I want for nothing, don't you see? I'm happy in my house. No use to shake palm fronds at me. I'm a rat. Do you think I'm a mouse? And no, I'm off to hide myself. If you've got eyes to see, just try and track me down, you lot. I bet you can't catch me. But if you do, I won't resist. Pour oil upon my head. I don't want care from humankind. Just burn me till I'm dead. And with these words, Rat bounded off and leapt back in the store. He sank his teeth into the sacks, and rice spilled on the floor. Captain Ahmad called for help. His kids, he asked them too. He really fired them up, he did. But none had got a clue.
Right, lads, take out these sacks of rice, till sacks there are no more. And when you've done that, sink the ship right near the village store. I wonder what's up Ratty's sleeve, what clever tricks he'll play. I'll show that rat who's boss round here. I'll make that trickster pay.
Rat found no food, although he searched as only he knew how. He scoured that boat from bow to stern, the blunt end to the prow. Then down she went, and in the hold the waves submerged poor Rat. No epilogues. Rat popped his clogs. He drowned. And that was that.